Hello everyone, I am Durgesh Sahani and we are creating series of video tutorials for CRUD operation on MongoDB in PHP using MongoDB library. So in the previous session we have seen how to save this form data into MongoDB, and now in this session we are going to see how to get data from MongoDB and show it to this area. Okay, so let's start now. Let me minimize it. Okay, so here we'll use PHP script. And as we are going to work on the same database and collections, so I'll move it outside so that we can easily access it. Okay, and here on this same collection, call on function find. So this method will return all the data from the collection. You can pass several options to it that we'll see later. So I'll say dollar articles equal to this and just click small letter. Okay, so if I'll just iterate it on it, so okay, and let's just print it dollar article. So you can see we are getting this data, and there should be two records. Here you can see this is the first one and this is the second one. And if I show you the database also we have two collection, two documents you can see here, or you can say rows. So we have to read one by one. Okay, so first thing is we have to design how we want to show the our data. So here I'll show you how we are going to show. First we'll create a div with class name rows and one column. So you can copy this thing actually and close this div and let's make it 12. So here we'll show the date and copy this thing and paste it here. Okay, so row copy, div close, and then inside it just copy it and paste it couple of times. Let's make it 3, 8 and 1. Okay, so here we want to show the image, so I'll use img tag and they should be upload slash, we'll concat it with the file name, and width we can specify 180 pixels. Then here we want to show, first thing we want to show is title, so I'll use strong. So here we'll show the title, then I want to use one paragraph for description and one for author. So this is the simple layout which we are going to use for show the blog data or articles you can say. So you'll see, we'll say echo and just use single quote as we are using double quote for the attributes. Okay. Here. So this is a simple design. The first thing we have to show is date, and if you notice, so while creating this date we have used this class, so we have to do the same thing for getting date back. So here you have to pass this article, let's say dollar article and created on, and we'll save some we'll save it to variables, let's call it this one dollar. Okay, and it have one function to date time, so you can call one function on the same this variable. So I'm just to date time. Okay, So this function will return the date, and you can save it into another variable. So let's say dollar paste. Okay. Now the next thing is we have to call the format function on this object. So you can show it directly over here. So just concat it, and over here you can call format and just pass the arguments like how you want to show the date. So I'll say I want to show date like this, DMYH minute and second, like this. And same like this we want to do for file name. So concat it again over here and make it file name, right? And you have to use the same thing for title, description and author. Okay, if you refresh it, if all good, then we should get okay. So we are getting this error, it's saying uncaught expected instance of this. Okay, so generally you will get this error because if you're running your 32-bit software, in that case you are getting this error because it will not get converted into this format. So you can cast it manually in string, so it will be converted into it will get the correct data basically from here and prepare the date for you. So just if you refresh it, you'll not get this error. See, so we are getting this date and time. So if you notice, time here we have 1930 and here we are getting 7. So if you change it to capital H, so you will get the same format. Here you can see 9:30 and this one is 9:31, and if you compare it, so here you can see 9:30 and 9:31:04. Okay, so you are getting the correct date. This is the description, title, description, author name. You can move it to right side, and for that you can add one class to this P. Class equal to text hyphen write, and if you refresh it, you can see. So there are several ways you can get this data and format it over here, but I'm just using the simple one. Okay, so we have shown this, and you can make a link over here on image or somewhere. So if you click here, so it will go to the next page where it will show this in detail. Okay, so this is the simple example how to get the data from MongoDB and show it to your HTML. And here we can create one more. So this one you can use so I'm just going to copy it over here and let's say edit or update, you can say, and you can use br, one more br, and over here you can say delete. That we are going to implement in the next session. So if you refresh it, here you have edit and delete button. Once user click on this edit button, the data should populate over here and we can change it if we want. And once you click on this delete, the data should get, this article should get deleted. Okay, so this point we will implement in the next session. So thank you very much guys for watching. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.